Alright, welcome to episode 4. We're standing outside the Creepy Crawler. We want to do a final interview slash extra to get you guys familiar with how we do things. And here in the present tense, we can actually give you a better view of what's going on. I really want to stress the fact that Wisconsin summer has been extremely cold and mild, which was a huge hindrance on our ability to successfully colonize the black soldier flies. But in the farther south and in warmer common seasons, I think you'd really have a benefit of going grain-free with your egg production. So we really want to stress the main idea of this was to completely colonize an entire system of black soldier flies. And since we're not in a native area for black soldier flies, our predictions did not come true because of the climate. So if you are in a southern climate, I think having a healthy population with this model will work out very, very successful to reduce your cost and feed. On most regular seasons in Wisconsin, we generally have at least a long period of no rain and very hot. This year we never did. It completely rained almost all the time until now, and the warm temperatures never really hit us this year. The inclement weather, we really came to the conclusion that we can sustain a healthy population of black soldier flies, but in a climate like ourselves, our goal would be is to build an entire building for colonization with the parents and to get to the egg stage. If we were to build a separate facility, that would allow us to control a lot of the population into the egg form. Once we hit grubs, we could replenish all the protopods in the field with grubs. So with the final thoughts, what we thought in the original idea was that it's going to be a colony and everything's going to sustain itself. What we found out in Wisconsin is that we are going to need a little bit more inputs and a little bit more control to get a healthy, sustainable population of black soldier flies. So with one final thought, we want to just take you into the protopod as a full scale in present. Once again, my disclaimer is that I am not a construction worker, so please find someone that can do construction very well.
How would you edit this design if you had the chance?
If I were to edit this design, what I would do is, thanks to Rudy, I would probably bring this design almost completely down to flush or very close to flush, and then we would have the roof hinge at one point to allow you access from the top. I think that's a great idea. This open space, we noticed, really has no purpose at all. My original idea is that we were going to hang more attractive units to attract black soldier flies, but in a native household or a native area, you wouldn't need that. So with the colonization of black soldier flies, like I explained in the breeding grounds, with cardboard this low, I think you would not need to have this excessive space, and you could drop it down. So that would be my thoughts. That would also give you a lot less resistance from wind. If you are in a very high windy area, you could bring this down and secure it a lot better than when this high above basically excessive waste. So I think with the overview of this, again, you know, I think the community could come up with a little bit better results for some breeding chambers or for areas for black soldier flies to lay eggs. Once again, this was my experiment. I would love to see how you guys do it, or if you have new ideas for us, we would love to get some input on how we can do that for the production of eggs for black soldier flies. So to get a better view of what a paropod will look like once you start going, I have somewhat of a healthy colony left here in this bin. What we currently have fed to them right now is some organic matter, lots of cow manure. I also had a batch of oats that was left on the farm, so we ended up soaking those in milk and until you get more of a sprout, basically. And then we fed it to the grubs, so that seemed to be very healthy for them and very happy for us, because we got rid of a waste product that would usually either get composted or buried, and we fed it to the grubs, which now ended up being a protein source for us. So this is a wrap up of episode 4. We want to give a big shout out and thanks to the University of Minnesota, the USDA, and the SARE group. I also want to give a big shout out to Rudy Craig, my family, and everyone else that supported us during this research grant. I also want to stress the fact that this is a community that can grow and can do a lot together. If you do end up copying or using some of our ideas, we please ask you to at least share your information, what you did better, how you did better, what your thoughts are. If you have any conclusions of yourselves, we would love to get the community involved and get everyone active in this experiment. We want young farmers to survive and we want small farms to survive. And we're all in this community together. So please, please share information that you have. And once again, thank you so much. This is the Creepy Crawler Grant.
Still Snoop Dogg and D.I. Guess who's back? Still doing that shit, Andre?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Check me out. It's still Dre Day, AK. Though I've grown a lot, can't keep it home a lot. Cause when I frequent the spots that I'm known to rock, you hear the bass from the truck when I'm on the block. Ladies, they pay homage, but haters say Dre fell off. How? My last album was The Chronic. They wanna know if he still got it. They say rap's changed. They wanna know how I feel about
it. You ain't up on pain.
Dr. Dre is the name. I'm ahead of my gang. Still puffing my leaf. Still with the beats. Still not loving police. Still rock my khakis with a cuff and a crease. Still got love for the streets. Reppin' 213. Still the beats bang. Still doing my thing. Since I left, ain't too much change.
Still, I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E.
I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E.
Since the last time you heard from me, I lost some friends. Well,